people say there's different causes. It's not because of poor parenting. It's not because of vaccines. It's not because of any acute trauma or anything. So there are some genetic causes. It runs in families. If a relative has ADHD, then there is a likely chance that it can run in families. What are the symptoms? There are three types of ADHD: the inattentive form, the hyperactive form, and the combined form. Combined is the most common thing when you have symptoms of inattention and hyperactive form. Girls tend to have more of the inattentive form, boys are more hyperactive. Let me go over some of the symptoms of all the three types, and at least six of them have to be present if you have to be diagnosed with ADHD. So some of the inattentive symptoms are: they don't pay attention to details, they have trouble waiting for their turn, they don't follow instructions, you have to give them single step instructions. Hyperactive, they're very impulsive, they're fidgety, you can see them tapping their foot, shaking, they're just like very impulsive, they don't have control over things. They talk too much, non-stop talking, especially you can see it with the little boys. She's smiling. Blurts out answers before questions are asked. They have trouble waiting for their turn. They interrupt often. Combined presentation, they have all these symptoms. So it has to be present at least for 6 months in two settings. It's just not in home or hospital. It has to be present both in home, daycare, school. So we usually have teachers and parents do those checklists. And if it's just the teachers or the parents, they don't have ADHD. It has to be present in both settings. How is it diagnosed? They do a little checklist where I think the best person to approach if a parent notices, talk to your teacher. They sometimes test them at school, but also if you go to your pediatrician, they do a little checklist. And if you fail so many things, and if it's consistent over 6 months, then I think they, again, it's not a disorder, but it's more of a symptom. So there are combined therapies. Medication is one thing, but behavior definitely works. Positive reinforcement always helps. So praise your child as much as you can, at least three times a day. That's a lot, right? So use time out or privileges for inappropriate behavior rather than spanking or negative reinforcement. Work closely with the school staff and be open to counseling for your child. And you are the best advocate. I'll just open up for questions because ADHD is so common, it's like 10%. So if you have any questions, go ahead and ask.
What is the treatment that you get?
So this is a combination. For the little ones under 5, you just do behavior therapy. There's a list of strategies you can work on. The psychologist also helps. And in addition, I think like just following the list, giving one-step directions, like when you ask your child with a